worship. Come and remember the love of Jesus, gathered at the table with his friends.
We come to receive from Christ the bread of life, the cup of blessings.
Come, receive the tender service Christ offers each of us.
We come to receive the challenge of the new commandment, love one another.
Come and contemplate the many temptations of a world that would entice us, like Judas, to betray the trust of a suffering God.
We come to travel with Jesus the way of the cross, so that our Easter, Alleluia, will take on a new meaning.
Let us worship together and reflect upon the life of Christ, that we might remember what the discipleship may cost and what it may reap.
We remember the Passover meal that Jesus shared with his friends, the friends who betrayed and abandoned him, and the friends who later risked their own lives to tell Jesus' story.
We remember that we too have betrayed Jesus. God, like people in Jesus' time, we will sing your praises and betray you every day. By eating this special meal tonight, help us to let go of the past and take hold of the future that you are planning for us. Amen.
The word of God declares in John 10 and 28, I give eternal life, and no one can be removed from Christ's hand who he has in his hand. This is the assurance of pardon that we have for those that have accepted Jesus Christ as Lord and Savior. We have been pardoned from our sins. The resurrection of Jesus Christ is the evidence that we have been pardoned, that sin no longer has us bound, that sin no longer has us captured, that sin no longer has dominion over those who are in Christ Jesus. This is the assurance that we have been pardoned from our sins because Jesus Christ died for our sins. This is the assurance of pardon. Amen.
Sent up to serve as he was sent. No The story of the upper room, Luke 22, verses 7 through 20, and Mark chapter 14, verses 22 through 25. Then came the day of unleavened bread on which the Passover lamb had to be sacrificed. So Jesus sent Peter and John, saying, "Go and prepare the Passover meal for us that we may eat it." They asked him, "Where do you want us to make preparation for it?" "Listen," he said to them, "when you have entered the city, a man carrying a jar of water will meet you. Follow him into the house he enters, and say to the owner of the house, 'The teacher asks you, where is the guest room where I may eat the Passover with my disciples?' He will show you a large room upstairs, already furnished. Make preparations for us there." So they went and found everything as he had told them, and they prepared the Passover meal. When the hour came, he took his place at the table, and the apostles with him. He said to them, "I have eagerly desired to eat this Passover with you before I suffer. For I tell you, I will not eat it until it is fulfilled in the kingdom of God." Then he took a cup, and after giving thanks, he said, "Take this and divide it among yourselves. For I tell you that from now on, I will not drink of the fruit of the vine until the kingdom of God comes." Then he took a loaf of bread, and when he had given thanks, he broke it and gave it to them, saying, "This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me." And he did the same with the cup after supper, saying, "This is cup that is poured out for you is the new covenant in my blood." While they were eating, he took a loaf of bread, and after blessing it, he broke it, gave it to them, and said, "Take, this is my body." Then he took a cup, and after giving thanks, he gave it to them, and all of them drank from it. He said to them, "This is my blood of the covenant, which is poured out for many. Truly I tell you, I will never again drink of the fruit of the vine until that day when I drink it new in the kingdom of God." Word of the Lord.
Jesus washed the disciples' feet, John 13, 1 through 20. Now, before the festival of the Passover, Jesus knew that his hour had come to depart from this world and to go to the Father. Having loved his own who were in the world, he loved them to the end. The devil had already put into the heart of Judas, son of Simon Iscariot, to betray him. And during supper, Jesus, knowing that the Father had given all things into his hand, and that he had come from God and was going to God, got up from the table, took off his outer robe, and tied a towel around himself. Then he poured water into a basin and began to wash the disciples' feet and to wipe them with the towel that was tied around him. He came to Simon Peter, who said to him, "Lord, are you going to wash my feet?" Jesus answered, "You do not know now what I am doing, but later you will understand." Peter said to him, "You will never wash my feet." Jesus answered, "Unless I wash you, you have no share with me." Simon Peter said to him, "Lord, not my feet only, but my hands and my head." Jesus said to him, "One who has bathed does not need to wash, except for the feet, but is entirely clean. And you are clean, though not all of you." For he knew who was to betray him. For this reason he said, "Not all of you are clean." After he had washed their feet, had put on his robe, and had returned to the table, he said to them, "Do you know what I have done to you? You call me teacher and Lord, and you are right, for this is what I am. So if I, your Lord and teacher, have washed your feet, you also ought to wash one another's feet. For I have set an example that you should do as I have done to you. Very truly, I tell you, servants are not greater than the master, nor are messengers greater than the one who sent them. If you know these things, you are blessed if you do them. I am not speaking of all of you. I know whom I have chosen, but it is to fulfill the scripture, the one who ate my bread has lifted his heel against me. I tell you now, before it occurs, so that when it does occur, you may believe that I am he. Very truly, I tell you, whoever receives one whom I sent receives me, and whoever receives me receives him who sent me. The word of the Lord.
Matthew 26, chapter, verses 20 through 25. When it was evening, he took his place with the 12. And while they were eating, he said, "Truly, I tell you, one of you will betray me." And they became greatly distressed and began to say to him, one after another, "Surely, not I, Lord." He answered, "The one who has dipped his hand into the bowl with me will betray me. The Son of Man goes as it is written of him, but woe to that one by whom the Son of Man is betrayed. It would have been better for that one not to have been born." Judas, who betrayed him, said, "Surely not I, Rabbi." He replied, "You have said so."
The Shadow of Desertion, Matthew, the 26th chapter, the 31st through the 35th verses. Then Jesus said to them, "You will all become deserters because of me this night. For it is written, I will strike the shepherd, and the sheep of the flock will be scattered. But after I am raised up, I will go ahead of you to Galilee." Peter said to him, "They'll all become deserters because of you. I will never desert you." Jesus said to him, "Truly I tell you, this very night, before the cock crows, you will deny me three times." Peter said to him, "Even though I must die with you, I will not deny you." And so said all the disciples.
Jesus, how hast thou our Father? The agony of the soil. Soul. Luke 22:39-44. He came out and went, as was his custom, to the Mount of Olives, and the disciples followed him. When he reached the place, he said to them, "Pray that you may not come unto the time of trial." Then he withdrew from them about a stone's throw, knelt down, and prayed, "Father, if you are willing, remove the cup from me, yet not my will, but yours be done." Then an angel from heaven appeared to him and gave him strength. In his anguish, he prayed more earnestly, and his sweat became like great drops of blood falling down on the ground.
The Unshared Vigil, Mark 14:37-42. And he came and found them sleeping, and he said to Peter, "Simon, are you asleep? Could you not keep awake 1 hour? Kept awake and pray that you may not come to the time of trial. The spirit indeed is willing, but the flesh is weak." And again he went away, prayed, saying the same words. And once more he came and found them sleeping, for their eyes were very heavy, and they did not know what to say to him. He came a third time and said to them, "Are you still sleeping and taking your rest? Enough. The hour has come. The Son of Man is betrayed into the hands of the sinners. Get up. Let us be going. See, my betrayer is at hand."
Father, the hour has come. John chapter 17, verses 1 through 6. After Jesus had spoken these words, he looked up to heaven and said, "Father, the hour has come. Glorify your Son, so that the Son may glorify you, since you have given him authority over all people, to give eternal life to all whom you have given him, and this is eternal life, that they may know you, the only true God, and Jesus Christ, whom you have sent. I glorified you on earth by finishing the work that you gave me to do. So now, Father, glorify me in your own presence with the glory that I had had in your presence before the world existed. I have made your name known to those whom you gave me from the world. They were yours, and you gave them to me, and they have kept your word.
That they may all be one. Taken from John, the 17th chapter, the 15th through the 22nd verses. I am not asking you to take them out of the world, but I ask you to protect them from the evil one. They do not belong to the world, just as I do not belong to the world. Sanctify them in the truth. Your word is truth. As you have sent me into the world, so have I sent them into the world. And for their sakes, I sanctify myself, so that they may also be sanctified in truth. I am not asking only on behalf of these, but also on behalf of those who will believe in me through their word, that they may all be one, as you, Father, are in me, and I am in you. May they also be in us, so that the world may believe that you have sent me. The glory that you have given me, I have given them, so that they may be one, as we are one.
The arrest at the gate, John 10, 1 through 14. After Jesus had spoken these words, he went out with his disciples across the Kidron Valley to a place where there was a garden, which he and his disciples entered. Now Judas, who betrayed him, also knew the place, because Jesus often met there with his disciples. So Judas brought a detachment of soldiers together with police from the chief priest and the Philistines, and they came with lanterns and torches and weapons. Then Jesus, knowing all that was to happen to him, came forward and asked them, "Whom are you looking for?" They answered, "Jesus of Nazareth." Jesus replied, "I am he." Judas, who betrayed him, was standing with them. When Jesus said to them, "I am he," they stepped back and fell to the ground. Again he asked them, "Whom are you looking for?" And they said, "Jesus of Nazareth." Jesus answered, "I told you that I am he. So if you are looking for me, let these men go." This was to fulfill the word that he had spoken, "I did not lose a single one those whom you gave me." Then Simon Peter, who had a sword, drew it, struck the high priest's slave, and cut off his right ear. The slave's name was Marcus. Jesus said to Peter, "Put your sword back in its sheath. Am I not to drink the cup that the Father has given me?" So the soldiers, their officers, and the Jewish police arrested Jesus and bound him. First they took him to Annas, who was the father-in-law of Caiaphas, the high priest that year. Caiaphas was the one who had advised the Jews that it was better to have one person die for the people.
The shadow of the cross, Isaiah 53, 1 through 8. Who has believed that we have heard, and to whom has the arm of the Lord been revealed? For he grew up before him like a young plant and like a root out of dry ground. He had no form of majesty that we should look at him, nothing in his appearance that we should desire him. He was despised and rejected by others, a man of suffering and acquaintance with the infirmity. And as one from whom others hide their faces, he was despised, and we held him with no account. Surely he has borne our infirmities and carried our diseases, yet we accounted him stricken, struck down by God, and afflicted. But he was wounded for our transgressions, crushed for our iniquities. Upon him was the punishment that made us whole, and by his bruises we are healed. All we are like sheep have gone astray. We have all turned to our own way, and to the Lord has laid on him the iniquity of us all. He was oppressed, and he was afflicted, yet he did not open his mouth like a lamb that is led to slaughter, and like a sheep that is before his shearers is silent, so he did not open his mouth. But by perversion of the justice he was taken away, who has imagined his future, for he was cut out from the land of the living, stricken for the transgressions of my people.
Oh.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory forever. Amen.